We're back. You're watching 120 minutes here in London at what has been known as the Brat Awards. And basically what we're talking about is an alternative and independent celebration by the NME, that is the New Musical Express newspaper, and its readers of the best and the greatest, as far as they're concerned, in alternative and independent music. And a band who have featured regularly in the NME's pages over the past 3 years or so. Of course, it's been the Manic Street Preachers. And Richie from the group is here with me this evening. Good. Welcome to 120.
Good evening.
In fact, first time I've ever spoken to you.
I think
surprisingly,
so, yeah.
Over the years.
I recognise you from your dubious past.
But we have 120 in particular. We're very supportive of the Manics from early days. I think we're probably the first people who played those bits.
I think so, yeah.
But you don't need that kind of support anymore. I think you're one of these termed as established bands now. Is that what you think you are, would you say?
I don't think any band is established. Most bands got a career of maybe 3 or 4 years, then they fade into oblivion and end up checking out door checks and the DSS, maybe.
Or you go the other way, end up sort of checking in those tax accountants and making millions. That's the other alternative, isn't it?
Yeah, maybe, but that's for the very lucky, the very few.
Yeah.
Then it could be us, actually.
Don't think. Well, I always remember the Manics that you swore that after the first album you'd break up then anyway, which you obviously didn't do.
No, I mean, that was our big ultimate aim. We wanted to be the perfect band that could make a record that sold globally, you know, millions, and that there would be no need to make another record. All we've ever been interested in doing is making a record which encapsulates a mood and a time, and then it can be a full stop, you know, bye-bye, you know, no need, go and live with my dogs on the coast, wherever.
Well, the last record was very well received for the group and was seen very much as a mature progression for yourselves as songwriters and also as musicians, you can put it down.
Yeah, I mean, it was called Mature, which is something that I find difficult to live with, but I guess it was. I mean, I think the older you get, the more life becomes more miserable. Definitely. I mean, you just, all the people you grew up with die. You know, your parents die, your grandparents die, your dog dies, you know, your energy diminishes, there's less books to read, there's no more groups to discover. You know, you just end up a barren wasteland just trying to find something new, which never really occurs. Now you end up finding worth in groups which maybe 2 or 3 years ago you would have just spat on, which is depressing, which I do all the time. I mean, I'm getting to Buffalo Springfield, which to me, I mean, it's a nightmare.
As the song said.
It's a nightmare. For what it's worth, it's the best song, but, you know.
Well, on that positive note then, what are the Manics up to at this moment in time? Getting depressed or actually getting positive?
Well, since Philip died, we cancelled everything and just went into a crabby little studio about a quarter of this room size and just been writing new songs, just like we did at the start.
Yeah.
Just trying to, you know, maybe...
And Philip Hall, of course, was actually the special award this evening.
Yeah.
Philip.
I know, Philip was a very special person to us. It's pretty well documented, but we spent maybe a year and a half writing letters, phoning journalists up, you know, people like MTV, you know, any address or phone number we got, we would write to or phone up, and there was, like, never any response, because, like, an unknown band, you know, who cares, you know, whatever. And Philip was one of the first people that ever called us back, and he said he was interested in coming to see us play in London, and we obviously could not get any concerts here at all. Because it's impossible. So he drove down to see his practice in, you know, a crappy little schoolroom in South Wales.
Yes, I mean, it's well documented. The guy, he's a very big supporter of new music, and that's why he's represented tonight at the awards.
And he drove down, he saw us play, he liked what we did, he got us some gigs in the Bullingate, you know, the Fog and wherever, and then just sort of looked after us. And even then, when we started to get some press, he just said, oh, you know, come and live with us. He'd be married maybe like a year. So we slept on his, like, lounge, his kitchen.
Right.
Wherever was available.
So I appreciate that for you this evening, with him being represented, it's more of a kind of a reflective mood that you find yourselves in.
I mean,
that.
The only reason we're here tonight is because of Philip. I mean, we've never been to one of these things before in our lives.
Hmm.
It was just a memory of Philip that we came here. We know the sort of band that they've seen en masse in these sort of public occasions. We're a very private band. We didn't like these kind of showbiz sort of awards.
Well, on from that, can I get a video out of you? Would you like to see anybody?
I quite like Roxanne by The Police.
Okay, we can go back in, Tom.
Thanks very much. The Long Police. Time ago.
Well done, fellas.
Thank you very much. We'd like to thank everybody who is on our side and everybody who voted for us. That's all that counts. Thank you.
One more. There's already been a tribute to Philip Hall this evening, but we'd actually like to dedicate the sentiment of this award, if not the delightful ornament itself, to Philip Hall. Thank you.
120 minutes coming from the NME, New Musical Express, Brat Award.